So here's my attempt at Jade Golems in the Rogue class. A lot of the Jade Rogues I've seen have either been playing Miracle with Gadgets and Auctioneer, or they've been playing the Pirate Package with Swashburglar, Small Time Buccaneer, and Patches the Pirate. And possibly those are better versions of the deck, but I just didn't really want to play those because it seems so cliche. So I'm going for a Nazoth route, and it's possible that even in the Nazoth deck, the Pirate stuff is better than Mistress of Mixtures. But Nazoth just works really well with the Jade Swarmers and the Aya, and then because of Jade Swarmer, you kind of naturally want to put in Unearthed Raptor, which makes you want to play a few more Death Rattles like Huckster. Once you get to the point where you've decided you want to play Jade Nazoth Rogue, it kind of builds itself. There aren't really too many interesting card choices in the deck. Mistress of Mixtures is in here just because it's a cheap Death Rattle, it's kind of a defensive card. In this deck, it's not like a control deck, but it's kind of slow. We got Ooze for some weapon destruction because there are still oh so many weapons out there. Bran is actually really good in this deck, it can get you some extra Jade Golems off of Jade Spirit and Aya. And I also found out recently that if you have Bran on the board and play Unearthed Raptor, you actually do copy the Death Rattle twice. So if you go Jade Swarmer, Bran, Unearthed Raptor, the Unearthed Raptor will summon two Jade Golems. And then there's a Dark Iron Skulker to kill all those pirates and stuff that are running around. So let's just play some fat dudes.
Valera versus Thranda.
You give me strength. Watch your back.
Wonder if I just keep this hand. My earlier drops aren't that good against Priest. Backstab isn't really that good against Priest. Maybe I throw that back. I probably do still want my earlier drops, because the early game is the only time they're going to do anything. And if he's a Dragon Priest, which is probably more likely than not, pretty nice to have things to do early on. So I drew the Jade Swarmer into Unearthed Raptor curve, which is pretty sick. I think it's better than Huckster into Raptor? I'm actually not sure. I think I go ahead and take my Raptor value here. And I can bump this guy in. This is a 2-2. He heals it up to a 2-3. He kills my Jade Golem and then he heals it up to a 2-3. And then I have to kill it with the Raptor, so I may as well just leave this guy stealthed. Because the Raptor is going to have to run into that 2-3 anyway.
The end is coming!
Wow, Doomsayer. That kind of surprises me. I can kill it if I want to spend an Eviscerate. Not really sure how worth it that is. If I let it go off, I'm going to have a 1-1 and a 2-2 on board. I think I like killing it. Like, yeah, if I let my guys die, I still have board presence, but if I can just keep them on board with their Death Rattles intact, then I just have even more board presence. That's interesting. So he's also playing Nazoth. Very interesting. So I guess I just pop this guy Skulker and clear here. I didn't really have another play that turn. I guess I could have just left a 2-2 up and like dagger Bran. If the Bran lived, it would have been pretty good at the Aya. I think I just play Aya here. Turn 6, I'm not overcommitting into any board clears. Just seems pretty strong. I wonder if this is like Reno Dragon Nazoth Priest. It probably is, right? Because you don't have room to play dragons and Nazoth in an all-out dragon deck, I wouldn't think. I could be wrong about that, though. So her Death Rattle summons a 4-4. I can kill this thing with Thalnos Backstab, Dagger, and 2-2. I kind of like the idea of trading off Aya so she can't be entombed, but he didn't have entombed that turn. I'm assuming he plays one, if any. So I think I'm okay leaving Aya up.
Here we go.
I guess I just play Bran here. Because, like, even a lot of my battle cries, if I top deck them, they're not that good if I don't have board. Like, yeah, I can get some value from Azure Drake if I draw it, but if I'm just losing to Draconid Operative on board, it's not really that strong. Yeah, that's a pretty good card. Isn't that good? 7 mana, 5-6, deal 4 damage. Compare that to Fire Elemental, seems like it skills up fairly well. 5-6 is better than 6-5. Deal 4 is better than deal 3. But it is an entire extra mana. I don't know why I'm talking about this, it's pretty unimportant. I'm probably just gonna run my two dudes into it. It's kind of a bummer that I have no follow-up here. But she does drop a 4-4, which is not irrelevant. 4-4 is actually very good against Priest. I guess I could have sapped that to leave my Aya on board, but Draconid Operative is so strong I don't think he'd mind playing it again. Damn, he got my weapon.
Are you mocking me?
So 4-4 into that, backstab that looks pretty good so far. Nice order, play Azure Drake at the end of the turn. I'm not even the least bit triggered. Maybe I use the Excavated Evil here. It leaves this guy at 1, this guy at 1, so I can backstab the Drake first and then dagger into this guy. Leaves me with a 4-1 on board, which shouldn't be that easy for Priest to deal with. And then I do have Nazoth next turn. Is Nazoth even good next turn? I have Aya, a Huckster, a Swarmer, and a Thalnos, maybe even two Swarmers. I guess it is pretty good.
Here we go.
And he's actually getting kind of low. Cool, he gave me a thing I can trade into pretty cleanly. Oh well, that thing doesn't even have taunt. I probably still trade into it though and then just play Nazoth. Nazoth is really strong here. I get 3 death rattles that summon Jade Golems. So even if he has a single Dragonfire potion here, it's not going to be nearly enough. Uh-oh, Kazakus can do some pretty crazy things. He has to go for the 5 cost spell here because he's going to be dead. Actually, I don't even know if I have lethal on board. Probably do, I have 15 for my biggest dudes. But yeah, I don't think that a 5 cost spell can really do, like, all that much. Maybe if he gets some really lucky polymorphs. I don't remember how much health he has. I think he has 20, and I think I'm only showing 21. Okay. His spell must not have been that good. So actually, if he just healed there, I didn't have lethal on board, but it was pretty much impossible for him to recover from that.
Valir versus Malfurion.
I must protect the wild.
Watch your back.
I definitely don't want these. I could play Ooze on 2, Raptor on 3. I don't get any raptor value like that. I think the raptor is definitely not worth keeping. Ooze is just a 2 drop, but I have, what, like 6 other minions I would rather play on turn 2? I think I'll toss the ooze. Argument for keeping ooze is that it never gets better in this matchup, but sometimes if I send it back I just never draw it, and never drawing that card would probably be pretty good.
No one. A natural mistake.
Wonder if I should coin out my other mistress here. Probably not really worth it. I'm not playing an aggressive deck, so hold the coin for maybe like turn 4 Azure Drake or something like that. Something that seems more impactful.
Oh!
I think I'm just going to dagger pass here. I could have played out the Mistress, but I can use Mistress to combo one of these shurikens next turn. Or I can just, I don't know, play Mistress Thalnos next turn or something. It just doesn't really seem like getting the 2-2 on board against Druid is really that impactful. Although I guess if he played Jade Blossom here, it would allow me to deal with the Jade Golem. So there are a few lines of play here. I can go Thalnos, coin, shuriken, and then use dagger. Or I can just coin double shuriken. Or I can just Shadow Strike. It seems like the Shadow Strike might be a little bit better later on to kill like a 5-5 Jade Golem or something. But I also don't really like using the coin here because I do have an Azure Drake for next turn. I have a hard time figuring out which play is best there, but I kind of feel like I just want to be able to coin out Azure Drake next turn, if it seems good. I could go for Mistress Coin Double Shuriken to clear his board. I think those are my first Jade Golems, so they're only 1-1 and 2-2. I can also just play Azure Drake here. If he sends his two guys into it, it's really not that big a deal. Or I could just go like Huckster Shuriken. Much more of a natural play, I guess. Let's just go for the Huckster Shuriken play here. And I think I'm even just gonna go ahead and dagger into this thing. If he takes this value trade, I have to dagger into it anyway. And at this point, if he tries to like value trade here, then I can just dagger and leave my Undercity Huckster up. Or if he swipes, I can just Jade Shuriken it. Wow, Wild Growth for mana on turn 5. That deck shouldn't have a 7 drop, should it? Ancient of War, I guess? Sulfured Power is pretty awful. I'm not sure if this card gives excess mana. Seems like it should give excess mana. If it doesn't, it's worthless. I guess I actually could go Mistress of Mixtures, Jade Shuriken, coin Pilfered Power to gain 2 mana. I'd be on 8 next turn, which could be like Azure Drake Fan of Knives or something. Sure. I'm gonna go for this. I don't actually know if it's good, but it seems cool to me to actually get Pilfered Power value. Ramped up to 7 so we could play a 6 drop. Makes sense. I can clear him with Azure Drake Fan of Knives, which is probably what I'll do here. Yeah, looks like the play. So I'm up one card, I have an Azure Drake on board, but his cards are probably higher value than mine, on average, and my hand isn't like super good. Alright, so with this Nourish for cards, he's taking control of the value game, and I might have to play more aggressively for tempo. Although maybe not since he spent an Enervate, back to being up on cards. So with 9 mana, probably just going to be like Fan, Trade, and then Tomb Pillager, Jade Swarmer. I could have played Bloodmage Thalnos there to get one more damage on the Druid of the Claw, but it didn't really seem like that one damage really did anything. I could have considered Huckster here over the Swarmer, because Swipe kinda lines up pretty well, but if he swipes I still get a 3-3 death rattle out of it, so this might even just be better against Swipe. This is actually like a punish against Swipe, whereas Huckster is just kind of a neutral result. So I have N'Zoth for my endgame, and he has infinite Jade Golems for his endgame, so I have to imagine his endgame is a little bit stronger than mine. I can get quite a few Jade Golems this turn, though. I do probably want to kill off Fandral. And then make some Jade Golems. I don't really have a good place to send the Swarmer, but it might be a good idea to just go ahead and trade it in to get the 5-5 on board. Because I do need to win this game through tempo, I think. But maybe I'm already in a good enough spot for tempo. This is also like anti-swipe insurance, kind of. Although I guess it's really only the difference between a 5-5 and a 5-4 on board. Since he'd probably just be swiping this to kill the Tomb Pillager. I think I like making this attack. I don't know, having the 1-1 on board is kind of nice though if he tries to make value trades. I think I'll leave it like this. I think from this position I'm favored. That seemed like the wrong swipe target because he could have just value traded into that and used the swipe to kill the 4-4 Jade Golem. Yeah, basically, this thing has one less health than it should, and this guy has plus one more than he should. So I guess I start by sending this guy in. Starfire. Yeah, I guess I play Starfire. Don't really have any other good way to spend my mana this turn. I'm daggering into something. I don't think there's any way I spend an Eviscerate here, is there? Maybe I do, actually. Keep the 4-3 on board. Like, I can dagger here and value trade here, but then all he has to do is hero power into this. I think I actually eviscerate. Just keep my minion on board as healthy as possible, so he has to actually have a spell to deal with it rather than just his hero power. If he was lower in life, I wouldn't mind him hero powering into it, but I don't think I can afford that value loss in this position. That Nourish is really dirty. I need to draw, like, Aya, Azure Drake. I need to draw something better than Backstab this turn. I probably need my next card to be, like, N'Zoth or something to have any chance at this game. Although, I've only lost one Swarmer. I haven't even drawn my Aya, so the N'Zoth isn't even that good. That backstab into backstab was so bad for me. Golems are a girl's best friend. All right, here's my Aya. I mean, I guess I backstab his Aya, play my own. I probably need to trade in my Thalnos to get a card. Bump into this one, because I is summoning a 6-6. I don't want this guy to be able to value trade. Pretty bad target. So he only needs, what, 6 damage. Pretty good chance I'm just dead here. Wow, he actually has Naturalize in his deck. That's bizarre. I could really use a sap here. Unearthed Raptor. Well, that's not gonna do it. He's showing 19, I'm at 20. So I have to assume I'm dead here. I guess I should have made this attack. Doesn't really matter.
Happy Feast of Winter Vale.
Gotta love the BM from the scumbag druid player. All druid players are bad people.